Hi guys, it's Jess here. I'm the brand photographer and blogger at Shuruk Studios and the creator of the course, The Brand Photography Method, where I teach entrepreneurs and bloggers how they can style, plan a brand photo shoot, edit their photos, basically my whole process, but all on their own. So you take out the need for having to always hire a photographer and you can create content anytime, anywhere. Before I dive into today's video, I also want to let you know about a free brand photography masterclass that I host. It is a 1-hour masterclass, completely free. It's like a little taste of what the course is like that I've created. But yeah, you still learn how you can style and capture content all on your own and the importance of brand photography for your blog or your business. So if you're interested in registering and watching that masterclass, you can sign up below. I've included the link in the description box. So for today's video, I'm gonna share my checklist that I use when I plan photo shoots, either for my own brand or for my clients' brands. So there's a few things I make sure every photo shoot has. And again, kind of reading my list off my phone so I don't miss any steps. But the first one is to incorporate your brand colors. So I feel like every brand needs to pick like about 3 to 5 colors that they're gonna use consistently throughout their marketing materials, their website, their social media, basically everywhere. You don't wanna use like every color in the rainbow. That is not building your brand. That's just being indecisive and, you know, changing it all the time. You just won't become recognizable or memorable or really stand out in the online world if you do that. So yes, first step is once you pick those colors, incorporate those in your photos because it's gonna make everything look super cohesive, super dreamy. So for example, I'll put a few photos up here of a client I've worked with, Christina, and she has a beautiful color palette. She likes to use a mix of like blushes, mauves, white/cream, neutrals, sometimes a little bit of green because she likes to incorporate some plants. Her brand photos looked so beautiful and cohesive because we stuck to that color palette and we didn't stray from it. The next thing that I always show in a brand photo shoot is someone's creative process. Because what really separates brand photography from other types of photography, like product photography, portrait photography, landscape photography, is we're telling a story, we're showing people what this person, what this business, what this brand is all about. And someone's creative process, I think, is so personal, so unique, and really makes anyone stand out. So again, I'll share a few photos of someone that I worked with, Alex. And we showed a variety of steps in her creative process. We showed her kind of like styling flat lays and taking photos on her phone for Instagram. We showed her journaling at a coffee shop, creating a physical mood board, so like ripping out pages from magazines and pinning them. We also showed her just like working on her laptop and a bunch of other things. But yeah, this gave us so many different ideas for the shots we wanted to capture. And again, you can see it really told a story of what it's like to work with her and what her brand is all about. So the third thing that I always make sure to include in a photo shoot that is definitely part of my checklist, and it may seem a bit obvious, but you need to include the business owner in the photos. This is, I guess, important, especially if you have a product-based business and maybe you're a bit shy and you don't really want to be in your photos, you just want to show your product. But I think it's so important for everyone nowadays to really, just connect with your audience in a deeper way. And that means they don't really connect with a product necessarily. They're gonna connect with you, your story, seeing your face, seeing you working in your everyday life. So whether you're a service provider or you have a product-based business, I think it's so important to have some photos of you in there. And they don't have to be always like traditional headshots. They can be of you working and just, like I said, like typing on a laptop, or they could be you maybe having a client meeting so there is maybe someone else in the photo. There's a bunch of different things, but this is something that is so important for a brand photo shoot because you are your brand. Therefore, you need to be in your brand photos. The next thing on my checklist is to showcase someone's unique personality. Just as an example, would you describe yourself as friendly and feminine and bubbly and chatty, or would you lean more towards like, I'm a more thoughtful, reserved, introverted artist type? But I mean, there's so many different types of personalities, and once you get really clear on what your personality is, I think it's, again, so important to showcase that through your photos and make that a part of your brand, because people are hiring you for you. Of course, they want the product or the service that you're selling, but your personality is going to really set you apart from someone else who's doing something very similar to you. So that's why I think it's just great. Embrace your unique qualities and write them down. And then there's a lot of different ways you can kind of showcase that through the posing, the styling, the products, the locations you use. But you can really show someone's personality through brand photography. Step number 5 is to present someone's products in the most irresistible way possible. I'm personally, as a consumer, just so bored and tired of seeing the same white background and a product well lit, kind of like photographed on that. Just doesn't make me want to buy it, doesn't really communicate anything to me, it's just kind of dull. And that's actually kind of what prompted me with this whole idea of brand photography, is because I want to like evoke some sort of emotion. I want to, I don't know, just aspire to a certain product and what it's gonna do for my life or for my business. So I think, like, if you, I don't know, say are a bakery and you want to make your products look super irresistible, like, I want to see cool different ingredients and cooking utensils, and I don't know, maybe there's different things you decorate your baked goods with, and you want to have like flowers around them, or I don't know, there's just so many different things. But your product photographs definitely don't have to be boring. I think they can be very high quality and you know, not too busy, but you can still make them a bit more interesting, and that can be by including different props or changing up the lighting, or even having that human element in it. So yes, definitely just photograph products in a very interesting and desirable way. Okay, the 6th step on my checklist is to highlight what sets someone apart in their industry. And I think brand photography can definitely do this. Again, you have to definitely do a deep dive on your competitors and, you know, what is their brand style, their tone, who's their target audience, and get really clear on all those answers for yourself as well. And if you guys are having trouble like really gaining that clarity, I do have a brand questionnaire that I use with all my clients before their photo shoots. And it's actually something I also teach in my course, The Brand Photography Method. I have a whole module on like defining your brand, really just uncovering these details so you have very, very clear direction. It's actually very important. It's the first step before you should even plan your photo shoot. But I do have a free questionnaire. Again, I'll put the link down below if you want to download it. But yes, gaining that clarity so you can really figure out what does make me unique, because that again is your competitive advantage. I mean, besides you as the business owner and your unique experiences and qualities and personality and your process, I mean, actually those are quite a few examples right there of what's going to make you unique. But yeah, basically once you become very clear on that, you're going to want to incorporate that in your photo shoot. Okay, my last step in this checklist is to inspire your audience. I love brand photography because I think the photos are always just so beautiful and so aspirational. And you know, you're not just trying to sell to your audience, you want to make them feel good when they come to your website or to your Instagram page. You want to make them stick around and just hit follow because they love looking at the beautiful imagery you've created. And maybe then they're more likely to share what you do with their friends and their family, and you know, it's going to spread the word. But you know, they're less likely to want to follow you if you know your stuff's kind of just boring and looks like everyone else's. So really be unique, really think, how can I just add beauty and excitement to their everyday life? So that is the whole checklist. These are all the things I go through mentally when I'm planning someone's photo shoot, and my own, of course. So yeah, I hope these tips helped you, and don't forget to like, to subscribe to this channel if you like this sort of content. But yeah, I will see you in next week's video. Thanks guys for watching.